First, let me load a device configuration into AcSELerator QuickSet. In this example, I'm using the SEL411L relay, and I'll be calculating some settings for the line configuration in Maple Flow for this demo. Note that this demo focuses on a small sample of configuration parameters. Typically, there will be several hundred parameters being calculated, but the same approach can be used for any settings or any number of settings in QuickSet. These variable names are important since they are unique to each parameter, and we use them to reference the calculated values in MapleFlow. In particular, we're going to compute some new values for the amplitude and phase of the positive sequence and the zero sequence line impedance. This is a very simplified MapleFlow worksheet where I'm using a mix of variable names that match the parameter names in QuickSet, and there are other intermediate variables I'm using to calculate the new values for the configuration settings. Here, I'm using these variables to calculate the magnitude and phase of the impedances. Once that's done, I'll use a specialized export command to capture all the variables and their values, and save the variables that match the QuickSet variables in a set of text files in the folder we use in the command. Next, I go back to the 411L settings in QuickSet, and use the import utility to navigate to the target folder. Here there is a timestamped subfolder that contains several text files. These map to the subfolders that are relevant to configuring the electrical triggers in QuickSet. All these files can be selected and imported. Now we see only the exported settings for MapleFlow in this comparison chart, showing the current setting values and the new values. If I pull up the MapleFlow document, we can see that only the variables that match the setting names are used and others are ignored. Finally, I click on Accept Changes, and now we see the settings are updated with the new values.